guys.
Welcome back to another episode of Conley's Corner.
We're still on.
We are still on.
Okay.
They haven't found where we film this yet.
Good thing.
So that's we're a really very good thing.
We're underground.
We have the fun information you need, information you may not need, but you'll always remember. That's what we do here. Yeah.
Remember scarring, whatever. You know, it's all
it's
semantics.
It's all wordplay, exactly. I'm Crackwise Magazine Editor-in-Chief, Kathy Vogel. As always, we have our fun ambassador, Ollie, and little cousin Mookie. And in the corner that we sit in, comedian Mike Conley.
In an undisclosed location.
Did you like that dramatic build-up?
I did. That was a dramatic
build-up. I was feeling that. I'm like, you know what? You deserve
a... I was feeling very Captain Kirk-y right there.
Oh.
400 crewmen.
That was really good.
I don't do normally do impressions. That got weird. Okay.
And it was impressive, too. I got to file that one away. Let's talk about the love of your life, if you have one. Mm-hmm. Have you ever felt like you've known them before? Like, oh my gosh, have we been connected? Maybe in a past life? Yep, it could be true. Yep, you could have been with that person a long, long time ago. So here are three signs that you may have had a past life together. Are we ready for this?
Yeah.
Something is very familiar about this person. Now, those who believe in past life connections say the person seems familiar because their reincarnated souls have the same or very similar features. Now, the eyes and hair may be different, but the facial structure is the same. It's all in the face. Didn't know that. Mm-mm-mm. How about this? Your subconscious is activated very strongly. Let's say you're having a lot of dreams about another country or a past time or place. You probably knew them then. So just keep those filed away. You might even have similar thoughts with the person that you're currently with. So you have that connection. It's subconscious. And
subconscious, unconscious, I don't know.
You feel that pulling sensation, even if it doesn't seem like the timing is good, and maybe the person isn't necessarily your type, the pull is so strong you can't help yourself. Now, don't go crazy, just take it slow and see where it goes, because it could be a love from a past life. Now, while that may be the case, what about the opposite? What if there's signs that the two of you in this life hate each other and you hated each other then, Mike Conley?
Well, no one can talk about hateful relationships over the course of generations better than me. So welcome back for that. One of the signs is that you get ready to go out.
Okay.
And she says, you're still wearing that? And it's the first time you've worn it in front of her. God damn. Really? Oh, God.
Oh, you can't win.
You can't win.
I know.
Another sign is, okay, it doesn't work out. The relationship doesn't. You get married and it doesn't work. You end up in divorce court.
Aww.
And you're standing there and the judge goes, you two again?
So you all knew each other then.
You did know each other.
Oh, snap.
And finally, mm-hmm. The big one that could, for, you know, even before you get that far down the road, you're out, you go someplace, you want to take her someplace special, someplace you've never taken her before.
Okay.
You walk in the front door and she says, oh, not this crap again. Just let go of the wood, Jack. Sink to the bottom. Rose don't want you no more.
Yep, there wasn't room for both of them on that headboard.
No, there was. You know what? There wasn't. Just let go. Give her the wood, Jack, and move on.
No. No. I said no. Bad.
I think that's what he actually did.
Yeah.
I remember the plot. Okay.
We're in a dangerous place right here. We're in a really dangerous place.
Oh, we are. So we're just going to wrap this up. Drink recipe at the bottom of the page. Maybe it's a familiar drink. And where Conley will be performing next. It seems so familiar. Aw, thanks everybody.